part of his arm right there, where you can see the death. And it's from a famous print of his, The Dance of Death. So you have this transcendence from subjective art into Hollywood. And then the woman reminds me of Andy Warhol's Elvis. And even though she's there in these poses, she's kind of like the Elvis, like this, just the type of prophet. Like Lisa Marie, Elvis Presley's daughter. And then you have the lobster, which again is a reference to Dali and to Duchamp with LHOQ. So you end up with the Mona Lisa. And I think the paintings really say that, you know, objective art is the highest call. And that's what my art has been involved with. The only thing, the only understanding that I've been able to really come away with as an artist, the only thing you can do is follow your interests. You have to trust in yourself. That's the first thing. You trust in yourself, but then the only thing you can do is follow your interests. And I'm sure it's for every profession, every area of life. But you trust in self, you follow your interests, and then you focus on those interests. And if you do that, things become very metaphysical. And all of a sudden, you change and you're involved with time, which is connected to past time, present time, future time. You're connected to human history, both and after. And it, the only thing you can do is that, trust in self. And by doing that, you have to have the transcendence from the subjective into the objective. And the only place that it takes you to is acceptance. And I believe that everything that we're looking at, we look at a ladder here or a pool toy, it's just a metaphor. These objects are just metaphor for people. It's, you know, Warhol, a soup can. That's a metaphor for people. Duchamp, this is kind of the most delicate one to say, to feel say about indifference. But it's objective art, and it's about acceptance. Picasso is also very involved in objective art. I mean, if you look at the physical way of cutting up and making collages and working with ready-day objects, but he connects through human history, and it's a much more the physiological, biological aspect of how to connect with what it means to be human and to deal with archetyping, to deal with acceptance. Picasso is a very accepting artist that to communicate everything's about communication. This is a painting called Waterfall Dots. It's making reference to like Courbet's Origin of the World, and there's just kind of a swish in the background. Like a painting that's just trying to tie people with nature. This was a proposal that and maybe someday I may. If I ever make an exhibition at Palazzo Grazzi. But I thought that this would be exciting. So this is just an idea. One of the wonderful things about being an artist is you can just have ideas, and sometimes they you make them, and other times they don't. But this was for the interior of Palazzo Grazzi.